Good morning all. Myself Dr. Deepa Manli, feeling honored today to welcome you all in the AICTE sponsored Atal FDP program on leadership and excellence. Today I want to share with you all our honorable Vice Chancellor Dr. Vishwajit Kadam sir birthday is there, so we would like to express our warm birthday wishes to him. Today we have with us Ms. Lavina ma'am. So I take the privilege to introduce our today's speaker, Lavina ma'am. Lavina ma'am is currently working as a senior manager, learning and development in Persistent System. She is a founder of out of the box business, Rent and Attire. She is having 18 years of progressive experience in managing and leading various aspects of human resources and operations spanning across high-paced business domains of IT, having led multiple teams in talent acquisition and learning and development during her corporate career. Through her unique concept, she is also spreading awareness about sustainable living. She started her professional career in 2002 as an HR executive and was associated with renowned IT companies such as Zensar Technologies and Persistent System. Her major stint was the Persistent System, where for nearly 11 years she worked in HR department, leading team in recruitment and learning and development. Her business, Rent and Attire, in 2015, which has been recognized as an innovative fashion rental startup and top 10 best online rental startup in 2019 by Silicon India Startup City. With this brief introduction, I request ma'am to proceed for the presentation. Thank you.
All right. Sarita, thank you so much for that lovely introduction. Am I audible to everybody?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Let me share the PPT with you all. Can you all see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. All right. All right. So good morning, everyone. How are we all doing today?
Good, ma'am.
All right. So let me quickly introduce, you know, Sarita has very beautifully introduced me, but let me also introduce myself. I am Lavina Laitunjam. I take care of, I'm running a startup called Rent and Attire, which is a unique concept where we have disrupted the current fashion market with our unique offering of designer wear on rent. All right. So the topic for today, which I'm going to talk about, is personality development. I'm sure all of you know what personality is all about. So before I start, I'm going to touch upon one very interesting quote, which I really liked, which is leadership and learning are indispensable to each other. Do we all agree to that, that leadership and learning has no end?
Yes, ma'am.
Anybody who feels otherwise, that, you know, no, I have learned enough and I don't think I need to learn anymore?
Just to interrupt, ma'am, all the participants are muted now.
Okay, all right. So I'm going to have a few exercises in between, and I want everybody to be to unmute and answer if need be. Let me first start on the concept part. Okay, I'm going to quickly give you a session outline. What is that I'm going to touch upon? So I'm going to touch upon the main theoretical.
Yes? Sorry to disturb, ma'am. Ma'am, do you want interactive session? Means because all the participants are muted now, so if you want to do interactive session, do you want interactive session, ma'am?
No. So what I'll do, whenever the interaction is needed, I'll ask you to I'll ask all the participants to unmute for that.
Yes, moment. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It will be fine, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Cool. Thank you.
All right. Okay. Coming back to the session outline, I'm going to touch upon the main theoretical aspects of personality. I'm going to provide a tool set to understand our personality and get more insights about ourselves and about others. We're going to strengthen our image in social circles by utilizing the concept which we'll learn here. And we're going to expand knowledge base to understand humans better, you know, by using few tools and techniques. So the topics which I'm going to cover is personality as a whole, a general holistic view of what personality is all about. You know, I'm going to also talk about Carl Jung theory of personality types. I'm going to cover a little about MBTI because it's a huge topic to cover, but I'm going to touch upon this and you all can do the exercise later at home. We're going to also work on determining the personalities and ask question to ourselves, can we change our personality or not? We're going to talk about personality pattern and I'm going to touch upon the triangle of success on that. So coming back to the first pointer, which is what is personality? Now, personality and its development is a very common word. I'm sure all of us have been using this that, you know, oh, this person has a great personality, or I don't like her personality. She or he needs to change her personality so that he or she will be successful. Now, these are very common terms which we have been using. We keep talking about personality, even suggest people to develop their personality, right? Now, there's no doubt that personality is a very important concept for every individual. And according to the dictionary, the meaning of personality is the complex of all the attributes. Now, I want to focus on these three, four things, which is very, very important about personality is the behavioral aspect of it, the temperamental aspect of it, the emotional aspect of it, and the mental aspect of it. These are a few aspects which characterize a unique individual. Now, all of us are not same. We all have different way of expressing emotions. We all have different way of the behavioral pattern. There's so many elements involved in personality that people find it too complex to dig deeper into it. Now, in this session, we'll try to understand the basic theoretical concepts associated with the concept of personality and try to understand them in the simplest form. A very well-known American psychologist, in fact, he was the first psychologist who had touched upon this particular topic of personality as a whole, you know, going deep diving into personality. As per him, personality is the dynamic organization within which the individuals of those psychophysical system that determines this unique adjustment to the environment. Now, this sounds very, very scientific definition. This sounds very deep, but it's very simple if you break it into, you know, seven different aspects. The dynamics of it, how we twist, turn as per the environment, the overall organization of the body, mind, structure of getting them aligned. The psychophysical, our mental way of emotions, how we express, how do we determine other characteristics, and our behavior and thought. And at the end, the unique adjustment to the environment. Now, all our personalities adjust as per the environment. Now, if I give you an example, as a kid, our personality was very, very different. We were more dependent. We used to look forward to our parents for anything which we needed. And then as we grew, we changed our personality where we realized our environment has changed. Now we are with our peers where we had to behave differently. We had characterized a certain way of behaving with them. And then as we grew, we get married, we have kids, we again change our personality based on the environment. So that is what it is all about, unique adjustment to the environment. A quick question, anybody who knows Carl Jung here, anybody who's read about Carl Jung, you can unmute and tell me yes, no, maybe. Anyone? I mean, a no is also all right. All right, let me take it as a no. So Carl Jung theory of personality type is very interesting theory. He had done very deep research on personality type. He was again a psychologist who had focused on the personality types. Am I audible to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, with the online thing, you have to keep checking.
Yeah.
All right, great. Now, Carl Jung, who developed a theory of psychological types designed to characterize people in terms of various personality patterns, you know, patterns like extroversion versus introversion, sensation versus intuition, thinking versus feeling, and judging versus perceiving. Now, these are very interesting concepts. So we talk about extroversion versus introversion. So we have This theory later led to development of famous, MBTI, which I was talking about, the Myers-Briggs type indicator. Now, this is a very interesting way of understanding our own self and also understanding others. Now, you all must be thinking, why am I covering all the theories here? You can also read. But before focusing on developing our personality, it's very, very important for us to know our personality. And in general, we think that we know ourselves. However, sometimes few different ways of, calculating this helps us in understanding us much more deeper. There's a small activity which I want all of you to do. So I think we all need to unmute ourselves right now. And just say hi to me so that I know that all of you are there.
Hi.
Hi, ma'am.
Okay.
Hi, ma'am.
All right. I've got enough hi now. We'll move to the next slide where we are going to do this small activity. Do you have pen and paper with you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Now, yes, ma'am.
Now I want you all to focus and understand which personality type you all are. So I'm going to show you a slide which talks about three different personality. One is extroverted personality, one is introverted personality, and the third one is ambivert personality, which have traits of both. So, so let's look at extroverted personality. Start writing 1 to 10. Give yourself rating of 1 to 10, 1 being minimum, 10 being highest. So, look at extroverted personality. So social, how social are you? Rate yourself from 1 to 10. Okay, then next is practical. How practical are you? Now, social means, do you feel easy to go and connect with people? Are you somebody who would take that first step to talk to somebody in a networking group? Practical is, do you take practical solutions like, going logically instead of going emotionally? Diplomatic is, at a certain situation. Now, all of us are working, we have been corporate. So do you feel that you're diplomatic?
Winter is summer.
Okay, someone will have to mute. Okay, affectionate. Then informal, the opposite of that is casual. So do you feel you're like casual? Materialistic, we're more interested in things than people. And it's all right to be materialistic. There's absolutely no harm. If I have to choose somewhere between giving more time to my gadgets or to people, I think I would prefer gadgets. That's my personal liking. So it's absolutely fine. Very active or, okay kinds. So similarly, you have to rate yourself introverted personality from formal, systematic, idealistic, less social, slow in taking decisions, take longer time in putting their decisions to actions, emphasize on future, and talk less and self-centered. Anywhere you have any doubt on any of these personality types, feel free to ask me. I'll explain more on that. But I want all of you to do this activity because this is going to derive a overall solution to, your personality type.
I request all the participants to solve this exercise to find out your personality type, as Madam said.
Rate yourself, and at the end of the extroverted personality, do a total. So these are 8 different types. It is going
just
to be-
wait, ma'am. If participants having any doubt about this, they can put their message in chat box. Yes, ma'am, you can start.
Sure. So the total is going to be 80. Out of 80, you have to score yourself how much total you've got. So we'll give 2 minutes for everyone to do this. Please feel free to ask me an example. Let's say idealistic. If you want to know idealistic, somebody who would not take the shortcut and rather go, they will follow after A, it will be B and then C. They go idealistically, even if it is slower or something. Any doubts, anyone? Please feel free to write in the chat also. I'm checking all that as well. Anyone who has done this? Anyone who has completed the activity?
Those who have completed their activities can put your score in the chat box.
Anyone who has got 80 out of 80 in extroverted personality? Sarita, how many of us are there in the session? If I know the numbers.
Hello?
Yeah, Sarita, how many of us are there in the session? If I know the numbers.
150.
Okay, great. I'll give that much of time, then accordingly, I'll move forward.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay, I'm getting to see a lot of introverts here. Okay, interesting. All right, I think most of us have done this. Okay, now how are you going to derive what personality are you is basically take out the percentage out of 80, how much you've scored. If you are more than 50% for that particular personality, you are that kind of personality. So, and there's absolutely nothing wrong in that, any of the personality, it is the type. Anyone who has any question about these personality type and any question which strikes on your mind that, you know, we should ask this question.
Any participants have any question about this? Please ask a question.
Ma'am. Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is it the percentage what you want, or you want the score in that?
So from the score, you'll have to derive the percentage.
Okay.
The percentage is going to define the personality, not the score, because it's not 100, it's 80.
Okay.
Ma'am, I have one question.
Sure.
So the traits that have been listed for extroverted and introverted, most of them I tend to relate to many of them from each of the two types of personalities. So how do we correlate with that?
Okay, so that is where you fall into ambivert personality, who have traits of both.
Hello?
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that is where you're going to fall in the ambivert personality, who have traits of both. Okay, some people may score 50% in extroverted and 50% in introverted, are somebody who are mix of these two personality. We call it ambivert personality.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah.
If you have something around 70% and 60%, where do you belong to?
So 70% is that you have slightly more introvert.
70% is extrovert and 60% is introvert.
Correct. So you are in the borderline of being ambivert that way.
Okay.
Okay. Perfect. Did it really, made you think about what kind of person are you while doing this exercise? Were you kind of thinking for 2 minutes, am I social, am I not?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. That's exactly the idea of doing this, because in our day in, day out life, we really don't get that kind of time to define what kind of personality are we. Because, you know, we generally kind of go with herd mentality. Everyone says, okay, I like to go out. Fine. I also like to go out. But have we ever, you know, sit with ourselves and define ourselves that, okay, probably I don't like to go out, but since a friend of mine have asked me to go out, I went out with that person. But personally, I don't like it. It's very, very important for all of us to know ourselves. Unless and until we know ourselves, we cannot really work on what needs to change in us. So these are just few examples with n number of things which can be listed down for extroverted personality and introverted personality.
आणि ऐक ना, आता तिथे डिंकाचा पावडर आणून ठेवलाय, ते भाकरी करताना एक चमचा घालून
घे. Mute yourself. We can also enjoy.
I'm sorry to interrupt. One of the participant is having one doubt. Can you explain about diplomatic?
Okay. Now, diplomatic is basically answering, let's say, you know, a question has been put forward and you really are not in for it. You don't agree to that. However, you know that the person who is conveying that to you is a learned person. So you don't want to argue with that person. So you put it across diplomatically, you know, for an example, I agree with you on this. However, this is what I feel. You know, not hurting the other person's emotions and putting it across diplomatically. It's a very, very important trait in an individual. So mostly an introvert would put it across very straightforwardly. You know, no, I don't like it. No, I don't agree with you. However, extroverted will very diplomatically put it across because he or she would want to be with people. They like to network. They like to be with people. So they would want to, you know, avoid any kind of argument on that.
Hello.
Yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, perfect. All right. So we'll move to the next slide, where I'm going to talk about different personality type in general. I'm going to talk about MBTI. Now, MBTI is before that. Now, Carl Jung, if you all get time, do read about him. He has beautifully quoted very wonderful quotes. One of this quote is something which I personally like a lot. I am not what happened to me. I am what I choose to become. And it's a very, very important personality trait as well. You know, a lot of things can happen to me, you know, but what I become out of it is what my personality is.
So if you get time, do read his quotes. They're beautifully conveyed. Now, personality test, which we call it as MBTI, which is a purely personality test. Now, the test which we did for Carl Jung classification is also not very scientific, but it gives a food for thought to us that, you know, oh, probably that is true. How do you really define otherwise extrovert and introvert? Okay. Now, the MBTI is a test that results in a four-letter result. Each letter represents a different type of the personality. We are now moving to a little more complex part of knowing self. Okay. So these are all possible combination of MBTI. I'll take you through the depth of it. Now, Myers-Briggs type inventory, MBTI was developed by Isabel Myers and her mother. This was in way back, you know, 80, probably in mid-80s, 90s. And they together worked on, so Myers and Briggs based their personality inventory upon the ideas of Carl Jung. I just talked about Carl Jung, who is a famous psychologist. So this was actually developed, this particular MBTI is a very well-known tool to identify personalities. And this was first tested on the women in industrial work during World War II. So if anybody knows, during World War II, we have had, a lot of women who were kind of, pushed into the shredder also because they were of no use. And anybody who has seen Schindler's List movie, you can unmute and tell me if at all anyone. Schindler's List. It's a movie about World War II and how Oskar Schindler saved close to 1,000 Polish Jews, the refugees. Anybody who has seen Schindler's List? Yes, no, maybe.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, great. Since you've seen Schindler's List, if you can express what did you learn from that movie, we would be happy to discuss on that. A small intro is also all right. Okay. Not a problem. Let me just quickly give you a brief on that movie. Oskar Schindler was one of the industrialists who saved almost 1,000 Polish Jews refugees from that World War II. And then after that, Poland was formed and a lot of things. So what I want to tell you this is, at that time also, these refugees, women refugees, men refugees, they were there. Those who were of no use were actually put into a shredder. Directly into a shredder, so that is where these women were trying to find some work so that they are not put into the shredder. And that is where Myers and Briggs also used their personality analysis tool for them, because they were really scared. They were scared that, if they will not be able to do anything, they'll be put into a shredder and they'll die. And that is where they, this tool helped them to understand what work can they do during that time. So their personality assessment questionnaire helped women to find the work in which they would be the most comfortable and effective, and which was very, very important at that point in time to save their lives as well. Now, what is MBTI? Today, MBTI is also used by employees, schools, counselors, and individuals for self-understanding and development, for team building, for leadership development, education, coaching, and relationship counseling. This is a very, very effective tool. Now, MBTI is a tool for personality insight. It is not meant to label or stereotype people. An individual's personality is obviously more than just four categories can define. So now we've defined it into four different categories. I'll tell you, these are different letters. So I showed you the combination. I'll show you again at the end of the slide. What is the combination? And you can also, while you're reading this, you can also put your name against each letter and see where do you fall. Okay, when we say first letter I or E, I is introverts, think best by themselves by processing ideas in their own minds. They can be tired out by too much contact with other people. This is the introvert trait. So wherever you feel you fit into that, start writing that particular word in your notebook. Extroverts, on the other hand, are usually energized by being with other people and often think best if they can discuss their ideas. Anyone, anybody, anywhere you feel that you did not understand, please raise your hands either on chat or just say hi on the mic. Second letter is S or N. Now, S is for sensing. So sensing is thinkers take in information sequentially through their sense and are most interested in the real concrete details and the here and now. You know, these are the hands-on people. They're very organized. Okay, Raghavi said, please repeat. So I'm going to repeat the sensing part or the earlier slide.
Raghavi, please put in the chat box.
Okay, so should ambiverts put I or E? So wherever you relate more in the earlier slide. Okay, so I'm back to the earlier slide because people wanted me to repeat. Now introvert, so ambivert can actually see where they relate more with this description. So introvert thinks best anyway at the end of it, you will get your overall scoring with the personality type. Now, let me repeat again. Introverts think best by themselves. They think that I know more. I have my own ideas in my mind. And if I'm with too many people, I get tired. I don't want to be with so many people. That is the idea of introverts. Then extroverts, on the other hand, are usually energized. So they like to be with people. They can discuss more with people and come up with more ideas with people. That is the definition of I and E. Raghav, you got it? Okay, moving on to the next slide, which is S or N. S is sensing thinkers. So these are the people who take a lot of information and sense things and are hands-on types. They really like to do things on their own. And then they like to, and they exactly know how to implement that plan. So, you know, right from planning to implementation, these are those kind of people. Now, intuitives are the ones who think in theories, aisa hoga to aisa hoga, this happen, then that may happen. You know, these kind of things. So they may know that theek hai ye karenge to wo hoga, but they would not know how to do that. Okay, so they would always be intuitive about things. You know, their intuition ke basis pe they are going to decide. All right, I'll move to next slide. Any question, please ask in the chat box. Now the third letter is T or F. Now T is for thinking. People with a thinking preference tend to make decisions objectively in a logical and impartial way. This does not, so now these are the thinkers who would think and then have logical solutions to that and then take a decision. Right, but like it's mentioned here, this does not mean that T people lack feelings. Doesn't mean, so if they're logical, doesn't mean that you don't have feelings. You have feelings, but you give more power to logic over feelings. Now, F people are people with a feeling preference tend to make decisions subjectively on the basis of their feelings and perceive efforts on other people. So basically, they would focus more on the subjectivity of things. Now, T would focus on objectivity of things, logical reasoning. Feelings here, F people would be more of going by the feeling, I think if I do this, then this will happen. You know, instead of looking at the real-time efforts. Okay, moving on to the next slide. Fourth letter is J or P. Now, J is for judging and P is for perceiving. These are two different things. We generally kind of mix these two things, but these are two completely different things. People with a judging preference like the future to be clear and settled, and they strive for closure. They prefer goals and deadlines. Now, when I say judging, it is more of judging the scenario or situation and then taking a decisions on that. So your goals or your targets are defined, and then you judge certain situation and then you take it forward. However, perceiving is where you sometimes assume things. So they kind of, you know, like their lives to be open-ended. So it would be more of, you know, okay, tomorrow we will see what would happen. they generally go with the flow. They do not have things very well planned that way. So sometimes we generally say, you know, I just want to go with the flow. We will see what will happen tomorrow. And especially when we are in college, we do that. Or, you know, in a lot of situations where things are not in your control and you just say, let it see, dekha jayega, jo bhi hoga, dekha jayega. This is how they perceive. Now, just a disclaimer, judging in no way means that you judge people or that you're prejudiced. It simply means that you prefer to work with goals and deadlines as opposed to open-ended possibilities. That is why I give an example of judging certain scenario and deciding whether should I go ahead with that or not. So they have their goals very well planned and set. Okay, now all of you have marked yourself, so we need four types. Now these are different types. ISTJ, ISFJ, so different kind of personality traits. Okay, I got somebody who is ESTJ. Perfect. So here we are literally putting in a box, but that's not the idea. We don't want to put anybody in a box. We also don't want to break the glass ceiling. We are not inside any box. We are not inside any glass house. We are all open to our thinkings, but this is just to define where do we fit into and what kind of person are we. Perfect. I see a lot of ESFJ. Okay. Now, each type has a detailed description, which I will give you separately because otherwise it will take good 1 to 2 hours to discuss and understand all these things. Yeah, so I'll pass it on to Savita later. You all can map yourself accordingly.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, moving on to the next slide. This is just for humor. Now, this test will show what kind of personality you have. Is the glass half empty or half full? If you look closely, it's more like 2/5 empty or 3/5 full. So what kind of personality do I have? So he simply says annoying, just for fun. Okay. Quick question, I would prefer answers over the chat. Can we change our personality? Okay. Yes, no, maybe. Perfect, I've got a maybe. Yes. Perfect. I'm liking the positive people here. Awesome. Okay. Okay. Most of you feel that we can change our personality. Okay. Perfect. Okay. Let me quickly read the slide and tell you. So every personality type has its strengths and weaknesses. There is no ideal type, just like there are no ideal human walking on this planet. None of us are perfect. We all have scope for improvement for everything. That being said, it is almost inevitable that at some point in life, you will say, I wish I had a different personality. You may want to become more outgoing, more in tune with your senses, more organized, more resistant to criticism, etc. Not surprisingly, one of the most frequent questions people interested in personal development ask, can I change my personality? Now, the answer to that is very interesting research I did while I was preparing for this. And trust me, while preparing for this, I also got a lot of new perspective about things. I always felt that we definitely can change our personality. I'm from that side. However, I did a lot of research and understanding, and it simply says that according to most personality type theories, the individual's type is inborn and does not change. However, individuals can develop traits and habits that differ or even directly contradict the description of their type. Now, how does that happen? A simple example which is given here is, let's say the electricity goes off in your house and you have to reach towards the door or to find the torch or candlelight. So you start using your hands, you know, using your smell power, your hearing power, touch part, and then you get the thing and you then the electricity comes back and suddenly you come back to your normal way of doing things, right? So the way your personality works is very similar. The environment you're in shapes your personality in a certain way, forcing you to develop traits and habits that might be foreign to your type. Now, giving you an example about, let's say, you know, me as an individual. Now, my personality is very, very competitive. You know, I'm very competitive. It comes naturally to me. However, I know that at times I don't want to compete. I want to, you know, tell myself that relax. You really don't want to, you don't have to win everywhere. You don't have to be the first. You don't have to be the one to, you know, be the first one to do certain things. So I have to push myself to do so because you cannot be 100% in every area. So somewhere we have to tell our mind, you know, or change some traits or change some habits to tell myself that, you know, you cannot compete everywhere. Similarly, for individuals, we change ourselves. An example, a person who is kind of, you know, lazy, doesn't want to get up early, however, has a boss who likes to start early. So this person would change for, you know, during that time until the tenure working with that boss, will reach on time, do everything. However, the moment he or she gets that comfortable zone, they will go back to their natural personality. So like a lot of you have mentioned that it's a very difficult thing to change personality. I agree with you all. It's a conscious effort, and the environment which we give to ourselves helps us to change our personality. But theoretically, it doesn't change. We just push ourselves to a different way of doing things. Personally, I feel we can change the personality, but the percentage of what we were will always remain with us. We just suppress it and move to the next way of doing it. Now, what are the factors that can help in changing our personality? Anyone has any example where they have changed their personality? You can unmute and share the experience. It would be lovely to know. Anyone? All of you have, you know, spend good amount of time in colleges teaching.
Minds are unmuted. If anybody want to share their experience, they can move ahead.
This is a beautiful forum to share these experiences because we are learning together on developing our personalities. So one good example is going to help others to learn the same.
Basically, over experience, you learn to be more assertive in what you want and not adjust every time to whatever your boss says or whatever your peer says.
Absolutely. That's a beautiful way of putting it across to everybody. What she's trying to say here is that initially when we, and it happens with all of us, you know, 16, 18 years back when I started my career, I probably had to, I was ready to adjust in a lot of places because I was just getting in. I was just trying to understand. The environment given was more of bossy and then I had to follow, you know, there was a leader and I had to follow. As I grew up, as I spent more time in corporate, as I understood things better, you know, again, the environment changed for me. You know, I made more friends. I got more comfortable with the stakeholders with whom I was working with. So I became assertive, you know, and that's what she's meaning, that personality probably is still the same, but the environment and the experience changed ourselves. You know, a lot of things can change us as a person. So there are a lot of external factors. Let me give an example. I always wanted to join army and I worked really hard to do so. When everybody was going to college, doing all the things with 70% attendance, I had joined NCC because I wanted to get that early entry in army. I did everything which I could. I got best of the environment also to, you know, prepare for it. But in the merit, I lost it with just one mark. Okay, just one mark. And there was a time when I felt that now what do I do? Because I only worked towards it. I did not know. I don't even know what else. I did not even take a different education to, you know, do something else. And that was the time when I felt very shattered and I did not know what to do, was the time when I really pushed myself to a different environment. You know, I realized that now this is not going to happen, and I didn't want to pursue that anymore. So then I moved to HR side and I started learning, understanding, knowing things. So changing the environment also changed my personality. I always thought I'm meant for army because I was very, I was physically very active in different type of things. I was gold medalist in shooting. Then my entire family was in army. So I looked upon them and I wanted to be very different from others, you know, other girls. That was my way of thinking that time. But gradually I've realized at times things would happen and we cannot change that. Certain things are destined. We cannot change that. But what we can do is change our environment to rethink and restart. So when I restarted in HR, I changed my personality. I've realized that I have to be now people's person. Wherein when I was working for army, I was working towards self-development. You know, how can I learn this? How can I get into those things to get into army? That was more of self-development. Here I realized that I will have to now work with people. So I will have to move from that introvert to extrovert. Now, I'm a classic example of somebody who was an introvert to extrovert because of the environment I got into. Now, HR is all about being with people, talking to people, communicating with them, you know, be nice to people in and around, helping them solve their problems. To do so, you have to be very, very extrovert. And that is where I wouldn't say completely changed, but a lot of things have changed. So, so claps to ma'am. I don't know your name, please, if you can help
me. I'm Dr. Janhavi Rao here.
Yeah. So let's clap for her. That was an example. Yes.
There is one more thing which I want to say is, I mean, like, you didn't have a plan B when you were in a college. You were striving for an army thing, right? So that thing didn't happen. The most important thing in life is to accept what is the situation, which helps us to tide over those, you know, breaking things to a moving thing. I mean, that's what I feel. So you accept that. One mark less, so you were not able to go. So then you move to a plan B. Otherwise, this transition becomes very, very difficult.
Beautifully put across, ma'am. That was a beautiful way of saying. And I, when I generally talk to people, now this is a very particular topic we were talking about, but when I go to a lot of places and talk on motivation, I generally tell everybody I am a product of flukes. A lot of things just worked out for me. A lot of things didn't work out for me. And since it did not work out for me, I chose the other opportunity and that worked beautifully for me. So at times it is also, you know, how beautifully you transition from one, you know, failure to the other successful things. How resilient are you for that? You know, you have to build resilience for this. So very beautifully said. I think all of us should applaud for her once. She's put it across very beautifully.
So thank you so much.
All right, great. Okay, so anybody else wants to share any of their experiences, feeling? This is actually, I'm not somebody who have, you know, who's been there, done a lot of things. I'm also learning with all of you. So it's a mutual learning. You know, you all should also share your experiences, which will help me to further think what more can be added in the slides. Anybody, any personal experience of change of personality?
Participants can share their experience.
Okay, all right, we'll move on to the next slide then. So now what are the factors that helps in changing your personality? First is by working on presenting self. Now, when I say that, how many of you believe that how we dress up, how we walk, how we talk, definitely affects the other person? Yes, no, maybe. In chats also is fine, or you can unmute and tell me. Okay, I've got a lot
of... I think S.
Yes. All right. And that is the first thing which will help us to change your personality, and is the easiest thing to do. Trust me, changing the external lookout is the easiest thing to do than actually changing our internal way of thinking. So the, all right, yeah, Tejashree has just mentioned for first impression, yes. Definitely, because at times some people we only meet once. Okay, not everybody, we would get enough time that they would understand us, and then, you know, they would understand our emotions, feelings, the intentions. So a lot of people we meet for the first time, and probably that's the only opportunity we have. So it gives you a, you know, window of opportunity to talk to the person. So if you're in a networking event, you feel that the person, the other person you're talking to is more impressive, you would want to talk to that person. And once you talk, you get that feeling that, you know, okay, I've spoken to the right person. So definitely for first impression, yes, but long lasting as well. It's something which we can carry all the time, you know, working on presenting ourselves well, not only externally, not only by the look of it, but even what we are saying, the second point, communication is very, very important. Any one of you know any of the great, any of the leaders in India or out of India who are not good speakers? Anybody? You know, simple.
Participants can put their answers in chat box.
Anybody knows any successful leader who is not a, okay, I've got Rahul Gandhi, so no politics here. We'll not talk about that. Anybody else? Even if they could not, when they started, when they were not even successful, they all worked on their communication. Every individual, you know, if we look at, it's as simple as that, you know, an artist, M.F. Hussain, when you talk to him, he also he articulates so beautifully. So an artist actually doesn't need to be a very good communicator. His art should speak. However, he also focused on, you know, articulating his way of talking very well. So we have to really, really focus on our communication. And communication are different types, verbal, non-verbal, written. So first thing first is the verbal communication. When we talk about verbal communication, it would be more of, are we open enough to welcome somebody to talk to us? Now, communication is not only about I communicating to you. Communication is also about whether I give that kind of comfort for you to come and talk to me. Okay, Amitabh Bachchan is a beautiful speaker. Dr. D has mentioned Amitabh Bachchan. Okay, yeah, so communication is a very integral part of it. Even if you are an introvert, it's absolutely fine. But even if you put across all the things perfectly at the time which is when it is needed, it works wonders for everybody. Yeah, so we can change our personality by communicating well. Next is environment. Now, does environment change our personality? Anyone has yes, no, maybe? Anyone who says no? Anyone who feels that environment doesn't really matter, you know, I will be what I am, wherever I am. Okay, so let me focus on environment part. Now, environment changes our personality a lot because it's a proven theory that the kind of people we spend our day with, we become someone like them. So it's very, very important that the kind of people we choose to spend time with or the kind of environment we want to be in. Very, very important. It's a proven theory that kind of time you spend with somebody who is, although they can be different personality. Simple example, very, very simple example, between, you know, husband and wife, they spend maximum time together. You will see after a few years, husband picking up traits from wife and wife picking up traits from husband. Agree?
Yes.
Yes, Dr. V, I agree with you. He has mentioned. Yeah. All of us, you know, as giving my own example, by personality, I'm very aggressive, assertive, and my husband is very submissive and very nice, very gentle. But with time, I see now I have become more, you know, submissive, humble, because I've spent a lot of time with him. And then he has started being a little more assertive. So we have kind of balanced it out, which is interesting for us as a duo. But in general, whosoever you spend your time with makes you that kind of person. So environment is very, very important for all of us. If you really want to work on your personality type, if you feel that you're an introvert and somewhere it's not working for you, you can start spending time with extroverts. If you are an extrovert and you feel that you're way too open about things and you want to reduce that a little, start spending a little time with introverts. You will see that change in your overall traits. Not really personality, but traits. So work on your environment. Now, working on our attitude. Attitude is the most important aspect in our life, and I'm going to touch upon certain topics on attitude here. How many of us know about triangle of success? Anyone who knows about it? Okay. Now, triangle of success is basically, it talks about three things: skills, attitudes, and knowledge. Okay. Now, skills is basically your skill can be your hardworking. You're good at time management, you're good at communication. Knowledge can be like, you know how to do certain things. You're good at learning science, you have facts and figures in place. And attitude is the kind of, attitude like self-motivation, self-confidence. Let's do a small activity around this. Now, have a pen and paper with you. Write skills, attitude, and knowledge as a header. And under skills, write the skills you know. So for an example, hardworking is a skill, communication is a skill, interpersonal skills is a skill, reasoning is a skill. You can also write in the chat as well if you want to. That will help. In fact, let's do that in the chat. We'll get more ideas. Let's write skills. What are the skills one can have? Okay, I'm waiting in the chat. If you can write in the chat itself, that will be helpful. Communication, all right. So asking the question in terms of your day in, day out profile, you all are professors. What are the skills you need to perform your job well? Persuasive skills, perfect. Troubleshoot the PBM, interpersonal skills, great. Multitasking, wonderful. Technical. Once we get 15 skills, we will move to knowledge. Communication and time management. Target oriented can be a skill. Cooking, creative writing, oration, technical, wonderful. Time management, great. All right, we've got a lot of skills now. Let's move to knowledge. Good listener, perfect. Let's move to knowledge now. What kind of knowledge you would need to perform your job every day? Knowledge can be knowing facts and figures, priority setting, okay. Skills, information, reading, learning, subject knowledge, perfect. Facts and figures, descriptions. Perfect. Teaching skills, current affairs, Very well. We just need two more and then we'll move to the next attribute. Historical, great. Descriptive can be one skill which all of you would definitely need while, you know, passing on the learnings to the students. One more I want, one last. Rules and regulations, perfect, great, all right. Now we'll move on to attitude. So what kind of attitude do we need to perform our job daily? Discipline? Honesty, perfect. Rules and regulations, assertive, motivation, straightforward, sincerity. I need four more. Applying skills and knowledge. Skills and knowledge is part of skills and knowledge. Ethics, very well said. Two more. How about discipline, optimism, integrity, commitment? Oh, we've got a lot now. Perfect. Okay. All right. Now we have written a lot of skills, a lot of knowledge attributes and attitude attributes. Now we go back to the skill part of it. Okay. So the first skill which was mentioned was communication and then interpersonal persuasive skills. So quick question to you all. Can we have interpersonal skills without having a motivation to talk to anybody? Yes, no, maybe. Okay, can we manage our time without being disciplined? Okay, can we set our goals without honesty? Okay, all right. So what I'm trying to tell you here is, we have mentioned all the skills needed to perform our job. We've mentioned all the knowledge needed to perform our job and the attitude which is needed. Just think. Just sit at your desk and think that, can you achieve any of the skills and knowledge without the attitude, without the attitude of self-motivation or discipline or integrity or honesty? Right? No, we can't, because our attitude matters the most. No skills can be acquired easily by reading books or, you know, reading online or doing those activity 2-3 times. But to do those activity also, we need the attitude to be disciplined and motivated, right? At the same time, knowledge can be acquired. You know, you can actually gain knowledge again by some facts and figures, reading and all that. But attitude is something which is our own. Unless and until we have an attitude to learn, to set our goals, to be more disciplined, we cannot acquire skills, we cannot gain knowledge. Discipline is 100% solution, perfectly said. That is the attitude. We need attitude to really learn or understand. So it's a very simple thing. When I hire people for my organization, for intern attire, I do not look at the years of experience on what they have done so far. I look at whether they are ready to unlearn and learn again. Do they have that kind of attitude? Because every organization way of working is different. Now, if the person may be very knowledgeable, have all the skills what I need, but do not have the right attitude to unlearn and learn and restart and build something new here, it is not going to help me. So I always use this triangle of success while hiring for my organization, and this has helped me tremendously. So the point I'm trying to make here is attitude is the biggest virtue. If we have right attitude, we can acquire skills, we can gain knowledge. Yeah, moving on to attitude itself. Now, an attitude is the way you communicate your mood to others. It is the foundation of success, regardless of your chosen field. It can be positive or negative. It is a critical factor to success. Anything and everything we do, be it working, be it being at home, be it with the kid, be it, you know, meeting friends, be it running a successful organization, if your attitude is not right, it will bring us down. A very interesting theory again about iceberg. How much do you see of an iceberg? What we see is just the 10% of it. The remaining 90% is below sea level. It is always the case. And that's exactly we as human are. The iceberg example is also applicable on human beings. See, 10% is above sea level, which is our skill and knowledge, which people can see. These are visible. They know we have skill and we have knowledge. But attitude is something which is 90% below the sea level, which we know the kind of attitude we possess to do things. Anyone has any questions? Write to me on chat or feel free to talk to me on. See, knowledge and skills are known to others, but attitude is the most impactful and it is generally unknown to others. We never talk about attitude, do we? Do we talk about attitude? Arey, iska attitude achha hai, mera attitude kharab hai. We generally say, no, oh, this person has this knowledge, he or he knows that skill. We talk more on those things. We discuss more on those things. We generally do not talk about attitude unless a person has bad attitude. Then we say that person has very bad attitude. Agree? Yes, no, maybe?
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone has any question? Anybody wants to share an example on attitude?
The mics are unmuted. Participants can share their experience as well as they can put in the chat box also.
Anything where you felt that, you know, you did not know the skill, but you were very determined to do something and then you achieved that. Any good example will inspire all of us. Okay, let me give you all an example of my, army days where I was trying to get into army. I had gone for SSB to Allahabad, and there is a physical obstacle test which happens. So you have a lot of physical activities to be done, and you have to complete certain number of activities to move to the next level. Now, I had not done any kind of training or any course to really know how it works. So as a very layman, I started doing the simplest one first, you know, so I quickly finished four or five of it. And then I thought, okay, now I will try for Tarzan swing. Now this is like, you know, a machan kind of thing. You go up and you have to swing down from there. Okay. So while going up, I was very enthusiastic that I will go and I will do this. And the moment I went up, like any one of us who are like scared of heights, or, you know, you get scared that if I fall, haddi toot jayegi, kuch ho jayega. So I was worried. And then I stood there for some time. And then I asked the coach there, I told him that, you know, I will not be able to do this. I'm scared. And I thought that now my next level is gone. I don't think they will take me in. So, then the results came, and results come after every test. So the results were announced, and surprisingly, I was in. So I was very curious to know, because, you know, I always felt that in army, if you say, you know, I can't do this, so how will I go in war front and do these kind of things? So I was shocked to know that they have put me in. And so I went to the coach and I asked that I have said no to jumping from, you know, Tarzan swing, and they've still taken me in. Why so? So, you know, he, and they're mostly the psychologists who are around. They observe you all the time when you are doing certain activities. They generally leave 3-4 majors who are psychologists who always observe you. So he said, I was observing you and I knew that you're a raw person. You're not a trained person. Generally, everybody comes after coaching to us. So we know who have, you know, done the coaching and who have not. So we could see you were raw. Secondly, you had that thing that I will go up and do it at least. You know, you had that attitude that I want to go and do it. Now, first time doing, any normal person will be scared. Thirdly, the good part was, which I did not know, out of 8, you were supposed to do only 5. So I had done the all 5 smaller ones. So I was done with that. But the beautiful thing he mentioned was the attitude is very, very important. And the attitude of you going up till there, people generally avoid that. You at least went there and then decided, okay, I may not be able to do it. Plus you were raw in that. So that is where, you know, he mentioned it, that attitude plays very, very important role. Only idea of you moving up till there was also something which we look at people. So psychologists have that thing. So that kind of, you know, changed a lot in me, where I felt, okay, next time onwards, I will not be scared of doing things. I will go try it and see if I can do it or not do it. So this was one story which I thought I should share with you all about attitude. Anyone has similar stories where their attitude has really made them do things differently or achieved something which they thought they cannot?
I'd like to share a small experience. My name is Gayatri. As part of our university curriculum, we have a small, an on-field exercise where we go to the villages in our country, faraway villages. And me being from the south of India, I am not very well versed in Hindi. And we went to a very, very remote village in Bihar. And so needless to say, they know Bhojpuri more and a little bit of Hindi. And I was supposed to take sessions for the students in primary, that is from first to fourth standard. Mm-hmm. We were invited to the school. When I went to the school, I first thought, how am I going to manage it? I don't know, how am I going to manage Hindi? And when I went there, I thought I should give my best, at least with whatever Hindi I know, I should do what I can and I should try to address the students. And somehow it was like a wonder for me, because when I started talking, I could make it. I think maybe all the movies that I watched in the TV that I saw really helped me. But for the first time, I could actually talk for 45 minutes in Hindi. And I could also respond to the students' questions and all. So I felt if I had backed out at that point, I wouldn't have been able to complete the mission for which I was sent. I think at that point, thinking positive and, you know, saying that I can do it, I should give it a try, help me complete the task.
Absolutely. That's a wonderful example of, you know, having positive attitude. It's very easy to back out. Very, very easy. You know, saying no is also very easy, but convincing ourselves and saying that let me give it a try is the most difficult thing we can do. But if we do it, that's the most wonderful thing we know about ourselves, that I have capability of doing this as well. Now, with this activity, you've learned that, oh, it's not that bad. You always thought that it's bad, but you since gave it a try, you felt, okay, I can do it. And in future also now I can do it, right? That is the attitude I'm talking about. That is where I'm saying attitude is everything. If we have right attitude, everybody can do everything, maybe slow or fast, but it can really help us to achieve what we really want to achieve in life. Beautiful, yes. Wonderful. Let's clap for her. Everybody's on mute. I think I'm only available.
No, ma'am.
Okay, great. Oh, beautiful. Let's move on to the next slide. Okay. Something very interesting which I found out while I was...
Ma'am, sorry to interrupt. One request is there. We have only 10 minutes in hand as we have to start second session at 11:30.
Okay. I think these are just last third slide. I'm kind of done. Okay. We are going right on time.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, great. Okay. Now, this is something very interesting which I came across last night only while I was kind of preparing for the session. And this was magical and it made a lot of sense to me. So while I was working on this, if you go alphabetically A to Z and put all the numbers there. And if you sum total skills, knowledge, and attitude, your attitude comes to 100. Anybody who knew this, I did not. I got to know this yesterday only, and I was very, very excited to know this. Do we agree to this? Now, logically also, it kind of gives us a figure that 100% attitude matters. Great. All right. Okay, so with that, I think I'm kind of done with my session, and I'm summing it up with attitude is everything. You know, be it a difficult situation, be it moving on to the next level, be it trying out something new. If we have the right attitude, we can really achieve that. We can move on to questions. Any questions anyone has?
Ma'am, now with sum up, you have nicely explained Carl Jung theory of personality types, different personality traits, triangle of success, then Myers-Briggs type inventory, and various factors affecting on changing our personality. So I hope participants have properly understood different type of personality traits as well as triangle of success, the role of attitude. So with this, I request participants, the session is open for question answer.
Feel free to ask. In fact, it's not even asking, it's discussing actually. All of us have got some kind of experience, different experiences. We can actually share those wherever we feel that probably I may lack somewhere, you know more. Feel free to ask those things.
Participants can ask the questions.
Ma'am, how difficult is it to change the personality? For instance, we find that children, as they grow up, they have a sort of set personality. But when they go to, in probably later on in high school or in colleges, when they stay in hostels, we see that there is a huge shift in their personality and attitude, which may be for the good or worse. We're not evaluating it that way. But so how easy is it to change the attitude, or how difficult?
Very good question. So changing personality isn't easy, but like I've mentioned the factors. Now, if they go to hostel, if they go and move out of the city, with who are they spending time with is very, very important. So that environment for them is very, very important. The kind of people they choose as friends, the kind of people they choose as mentors is going to affect their personality, because from school to college is very, very delicate transition. Very delicate transition. They're you know, spoon fed till school, and then they're moving to college where they are now a little on their own, not totally, but a little on their own. So that is where they choosing the right environment. That environment is going to set the surroundings for them, and that surrounding is going to define their day in day out habits, and those habits are finally going to change into attitude. So it is not going to be easy. So what best we can do is putting them across in the right environment. You know, nowadays I meet a lot of mothers who talk about that my son is hyperactive, my daughter is hyperactive, and I want to channelize their energy. So I've been hearing that particular word, channelizing the energy. Then I read about it and I realized that they're not wrong. Because if they have so much of energy, you have to put them in the right track, right set of things. If they are hyperactive, maybe put them in sports and see whether they like it or not like it. And then if they don't like it, then try something else. It's a continuous process of improvement by giving them the right environment. And with that, they catch the right attitude. I hope I could answer your question.
Hello, ma'am. I have one question. I work for industry, I'm not a faculty. So actually, the skills and knowledge is what I already acquired, and which I can, if I attend any interview, I can very well put it across. But attitude is something which is not expressive. So how I should work upon showing that I have good attitude too?
During the interview, you mean?
Yeah.
Perfect. You know, it starts with a simple entering the room and saying hi very nicely. You know, since I have been interviewing people for good 12, 14 years, my first impression about somebody who is coming in for interview is how do they walk in and how do they greet? Very, very important thing. If the person is coming with a smiling face, it gives me a positive vibe. And that positive vibe is very, very interesting, important to move ahead with a good conversation. Very, very important. And all of us agree to that, right? None of us would want to see unhappy faces or not so expressive faces. We may have, we may have a face which is not expressive, but whenever it is needed, we may have to express ourselves. So it's very, very important you start from there. First step is to keep, yourself presentable. So you enter, you greet nicely, you sit, you start the conversation on positive notes. Very, very important. You're all positive. You know, a lot of people during interview when I've been hiring would say, when you ask a question, why are you looking for change? And they would simply say, I'm not happy with my boss. Now, I am not interested to hire you as well, because probably you may not happy with this boss as well. It's as, you can put it across very differently that, the thought process doesn't match. Or I want to do something different. Probably my career is not going in that track. Instead of putting it across on a person, there are different ways of communication. That is where I said communication is very, very important. You may feel the same. You may wanted to say the same thing that, probably the boss and your thought process doesn't match. But how you say it also is going to make a difference. So very, very important is the attitude is a combination of your behavior, your communication, your environment. Like I said, these 4 or 5 factors. Focus on those things.
Okay, sure, ma'am. Thanks.
Ma'am, we will wind up our first session here. So before ending up, a few of the participants have requested this PPT material. So if possible, can you mail that material to Savita, ma'am, so that she can put on the group?
Sure, I can do that.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am, for accepting our invitation. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much for giving me this time. And it was wonderful to interact with all of you. I would love to interact more as and when possible.
Yes,
thank you. Have a good day. Have a good day, everyone. Bye.
Okay, we will have a 5-minute break. Then we will start with second session at 11:30. So sharp join at 11:30.